Hi, I'm Phyllis, southernfrugal.com. Today I want to do a little video on the Bissell carpet cleaner. Now, I got the carpet cleaner, I think it was right after Christmas, maybe even the first of the year last year. And the main reason I got it was because when you rent the Rug Doctor, which I have done multiple times, by the time you've rented it three times, you could have paid for this. Now, I got this from Amazon. It was $112 with free shipping. I also checked the price in our local Walmart just a week or so ago, and it's $159. So when you order over the internet, if you can get free shipping, you usually get the better deal, because obviously they're going to add some cost to it to be carried in the store and that kind of thing. So anyway, I've got to where I order much stuff from Amazon. I also order from Walmart online because I think you get a better product than what's in the store a lot of times. Anyway, back to the carpet cleaner. I went ahead and cleaned the rug in our office in the back of the house. That rug is 100% wool, and it cleaned up great, y'all. That rug, it's at least 30 years old, at least. And it cleaned up, it looks like a new rug. I also cleaned the rug in our den. Now, in the den is where the dogs come in and out a lot. And even though it didn't look dirty, I knew it had to be dirty. Well, it was super dirty. In fact, I was almost ashamed that I had not cleaned it in like 2 years. But it doesn't show dirt at all, but it was super dirty. The water from the cleaner was absolutely black when I got through. So what I end up doing is, and I used to do this with Rug Doctor too, is I go ahead and clean the rugs, and then I go through it again with fresh water, simply because I just don't want all of that soapy water still on the rugs. And I think they do look better when you go over them again with clear water. So anyway, let's get started with this. I wanted to show y'all how to take it apart and put it back together. So hold on, let me get the camera turned around. All right, so here's what it looks like. And the only thing that you have to do is put the arm on it, and you just put the little screws in it. It's been so long since I put it together, I don't even remember now. But it's not difficult at all to get it assembled there. All right, so the cord is over here, and you can just turn these little things like that and get the cord off. And so down here is where you've got the little bucket that holds the water. So what you do is just step on this, kind of like a vacuum cleaner, and pull it down. And you have to lift that up, and then you can just pick it right out. So what happens then is this, you need to take the top of it off. I'm not sure I can do this with one hand. Let's see if I can. Yeah, there we go. So you just pick that off. Let me sit this aside. Now this comes with a little measuring cup that's attached that just really fits right in this little hole here. You see that? Fits right in there. And I've already poured out my cleaning fluid. There's what the little cup looks like. You don't have to use much. And so then what I want to do is go into the kitchen, and I'm going to fill this little bladder here. It's a little plastic thing on the inside of it. I'm going to put the cleaning fluid in here and fill this up with water. And that's going to be the cleaning liquid you use. Now, as you use that up, this bladder that's in there is going to shrink right way up, and the dirty water is going to come in beside it. Now, the instructions say make sure you don't put this in the microwave to heat the water up. And I am actually not going to use hot water. I'm going to use just barely warm water, simply because this rug is 100% wool. Now, these rugs were made in Russia, and this one and the one in the living room and the dining room all kind of match. They all came from Russia, I don't know, maybe 20 years ago. Anyway, they've held up really, really well. So I know it doesn't look dirty, but it has to be, okay? So we're gonna go in and get some water in this and put the cleaning fluid right in there, and we'll be right back. All right, I have gotten the bladder filled up with water, plus I added the cleaning fluid for the carpet, and you only put it up to that line, so it's only, that looks like about a third of a cup maybe. And this goes right in there. That's where you store it. I can't do that with one hand. Right in there. All right, so now we're ready to put the lid back on. And what you do is just sit it on here like that. And then when you pull the handle up, then it's in place. So then we're going to turn it around and sit it right down in there. There. You want to make sure it's in there secure, and you're ready to start cleaning the carpet now. You want to put the handle down and just click it like that. So to remove it, you lift it up and turn it like that, and then you can pick the whole top up, top off, including the handle. Sorry, I was talking and wasn't paying attention. All right, so you want to put the handle down like that. Then we're ready to lift this up. Let it click. There. And let me get it plugged in and get y'all situated on the camera, and we'll be back. All right, we are ready to start cleaning, and don't know how much of that y'all can see. Yeah. All right, so the little button to turn it on is right on the back, right back here. It's going to make a little noise, so what we're going to do is make one pass that way, and then we're going to pull it all the way backwards, and the whole time we're going to have down the little handle that releases the cleaning fluid. Here we go. Clean this whole rug. You keep the handle, little sprayer down, all the way down and then all the way back, and then you vacuum it up and down, and then I'll be turning the vacuum part kind of diagonally and vacuum it real good. It'll dry, and really my rug in the office and in the den dried in less than 2 hours, but it's also July, so, but anyway, we'll be back when I get through cleaning this. It shouldn't take any time at all. One of the things you want to make sure you do is vacuum whatever you're cleaning, carpet or rugs, super, super well before you even start, and that'll make your job a lot easier. All right, we'll be back. All right, we just finished cleaning this and using the Bissell rug cleaner, and it's a good idea to have a towel, an old towel, to go around the edge if you're cleaning rugs, because it will kind of get on the floor a little bit. But anyway, we are finished with this part of it. Now I am going to go over it and rinse it with plain water. So, and of course they say no, you don't need to do that, but it makes me feel better when I do that. All right, so I'm going to take this out now. Let me turn this down so y'all can see. All right, so what I'm going to do now is take this out. Uh-oh, sorry, I didn't mean to jiggle y'all. I'm going to take this out and dump it. I'm actually going to dump it in the commode, but I want y'all to see what it looks like when I get it out there. Can y'all see the water? Pretty dirty, huh? And I don't really think it faded any at all, not from anything I can see. So I'm going to go dump this out, get some fresh water, and then do a rinse job on the rug. We'll be back. I wanted to come back a minute because I remembered when I was cleaning the rug, I did take this out of the box and clean the carpet in the RV. I had forgotten about that. So I did use it in there, but that wasn't a very good example because that carpet wasn't really dirty. It had been cleaned when we purchased the RV, professionally cleaned, so it really wasn't that dirty. But I had put baking soda all over it, and I wanted to wet it. I'd vacuumed it up real good, but I wanted to actually put water on it, and that's what I did. I used just plain water. So I had used that. I'd already forgotten that. That's been a little while back. Anyway, let me get some clean water. We're going to rinse this. All right, I got it all cleaned out with the cleaner fluid that was in there and then the dirty water. Now, I found the best way to do this is take it into the shower where I've got the massage shower head that's got the real powerful stream, and or either take it outside and use the water hose. Steely, look at this. What are you doing? He's coming. Come here. Come here, you silly. Oh, he hears me on the camera. Here's the dog that just walked over my clean carpet, didn't you, huh? Anyway, with that big stream of water, you can clean it out really good. And actually, I think it would be better to go outside with your water hose because now I've got to clean my shower, at least the base of it. But anyway, we're going to go over this rug then with the fresh water. Now, I'm not going to put as much on as I did with the with the cleaning fluid, but I do want to rinse it some, you know, just to say I did. And so anyway, when we get ready to, I'm going to go ahead and go over it with less water, but rinsing it. And then we're going to clean this out because that's a little harder to do because you have to clean out the whole front section too. But the other thing that adding the water does is going to clean out all the tubes and everything from any kind of cleaning fluid that might be still in there. Because someone wrote in with a comment and said to be sure and do that because they left there sitting for a while and it caused a problem in the lines. It can, I think, actually stop the lines up. Are you ready to get down? He likes to be on camera. You see the camera? Say hello to everybody. All right, you go in yonder with Papa. Go, go. Anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and rinse this, and we'll be back, and I'll show you how I clean it out. All right, we'll be back. All right, we finished cleaning it and going over the rug with the plain water. And I wanted to show you this. I was using this towel to go around the edges where I got some water on the floor. But let me step on this because it's still a little wet there. And let's see if it faded. Whoops. And it did not, or if it did, just a little bit. So mostly what I'm seeing is dirt. Yeah. All right. So let's take this out. Now, sorry for all the jiggling. Let's take this, and I will take y'all in the bathroom with me and show you how to get this thing clean. We'll be back. All right, so this second water was just about as dirty as the first where I rinsed it. I wanted to show you, I'm not going to go over it again because I'm just tired, but I wanted to show you, you also need to clean this thing out. Just grasping it and pulling it up. Because see all the stuff that's in there? That's, of course, fibers from the rug. Anyway, I think it looks pretty good. Now, once it gets thoroughly dry, I'll be vacuuming it. I did do it at a slight angle the second time. It really is only just very damp wet now. And I did turn the back of it over, and it's not even wet on the underside, which is great. All right, let's go clean this out. All right, we are ready to clean this out. Now, I did dump this dirty water into the commode. So what I'm going to do is, I think I've got this shower head on the massage thing, so it comes out real strong. So here we go. So I'm just filling up that bladder part in there. I'm not the bladder, but the outside edge of it to get all that dirty water out. Just turn that upside down there. Now what y'all are seeing is fibers actually from the rug. get it out of this thing, you have to kind of run a heavy stream of water through it. But it will get it all out. Eventually. Yeah, I think it'd actually be better to take it outside and use a water hose. Let some of that fiber go back the other way. And then we're gonna rip our lid out too. And some of that fiber gets stuck right back in there. You have to kind of jiggle it around to get it out. Like that. Alright, I think we got it all clean. We're ready to put it up now. Alright, we'll be right back. Alright, we are back and I have finished, of course, cleaning the carpet, cleaned out the little container and cleaned out that front part of it. But I wanted to mention, this jug makes 24 gallons. My guess is that's enough to clean wall-to-wall carpeting all over a house, probably 2,000 square feet. It's a lot because you only put a little small amount in the cup. Now, I went ahead and rinsed this rug in here, and I did it mainly because it's wool. I just felt better doing that. But it does say it's got Scotchgard in there, so it's supposed to keep your carpets clean longer, I guess. But anyway, so I would say that this carpet cleaner, this Bissell cleaner, is well worth it. Now, they have one that's for if you have pets like dogs that shed and everything. Now, our dogs are poodles, so they don't really shed. You have to trim them. But I do have long hair, and I'll have to say I got a lot of long hair up from certainly the rug in the den. I think it kind of works its way into the carpet, you know, or into the rugs. But anyway, this is a short nap oriental type rug, and it is 100% wool. Now, it's just barely damp now, and this machine did not wet the back side of it. So I was, you know, really happy with that. So I would definitely recommend the machine. I have got it on my website under products I highly recommend. I am not an affiliate of Bissell, y'all. So if you buy it through Amazon, I get a couple of pennies on the dollar. It's nothing really. But if you are interested in purchasing it, I would say check with Walmart and other department stores and check online. I think that I certainly got it cheaper by ordering it through Amazon. Plus, I had free shipping. Now, if I had not had free shipping, I might have gotten it cheaper somewhere else. But basically, I ordered from Amazon, and with free shipping, it was certainly a better deal than it was at Walmart. So I'm talking about in the store itself. So anyway, all right, well, that's all I've got, y'all. I think it works great. My carpet in the den and this one actually were much dirtier than I thought they were. They didn't look dirty, but they were dirty. And of course, it smells really nice in here now. I've rinsed it, and of course, even the rinse water was a little dirty too. So I think I've shown y'all how to take it apart and clean it out. And my suggestion would be, if it's warm weather, to take that outside and rinse it out with the water hose, because you can get more pressure to get any dirt and hair out of that front part of the machine. So anyway, that's all I've got, y'all. I'm happy with the job that it did. I will wait until tomorrow to make sure it's 100% totally dry, and then I'll just vacuum it real good. And it definitely looks good now, and I can tell it's not completely dry yet, but it definitely looks cleaner, I'll have to say. All right, y'all, we will see y'all next time. Bye for now.